I'm Ginger Conajero.
And I'm Cor Canaris. And welcome to Teeth. From art to music to film, we'll give you one hard, fast look.
But you'll still be wanting more. Welcome back to the show that gives you the three C's, creativity, culture, and charm, supplied in evening doses by me, Ginger Conajero.
And me, Cor Canaris. The world is but a stage, and we are all but players. But we'd mostly just like to watch.
Yeah, because it's so interesting?
No, because everyone else on the stage, they're jerks.
All right, here's the three in one.
Three!
Adaptations can't possibly be as good as the originals, you say? We say balderdash. Now, in celebration of the first use of balderdash on the show, we present to you the top three movies based on stage plays. Number three, Closer. Besides having Natalie Portman as a stripper, it's one of the most affecting and moving stories in years. There's also Clive Owen. Aw, yeah. Number two, Zsa Zsa Zsatorna. I know we're cheating because it's a movie based on a stage play, based on a comic, but we make the lists. Though a lot was lost in translation, we gotta love it when a gay superhero musical gets greenlit. Number one, The Rocky Horror Picture Show. Jeez, this three-in-one has more cross-dressing than usual. The recent Glee revival reminded us how great this is, and hopefully, it'll be staged again.
What could we do to possibly make this show better?
Dancing girls. Iroh? Dancing girls.
Here's a bonus round. We've shown you the best movies based on stage plays. Well, we're giving you the movies that should be stage plays, if they aren't already. Bobocop. No, seriously, just watch the dang thing. Video Kicking. It'd be a comedy musical. What else could it be? Point Break. The Patrick Swayze and Keanu Reeves actioner is here because it already has its own stage play, where they got members of the audience to join them. Week in and week out, Quark sits down with two of the sexiest people in the Philippines, Kim Arvilla and Erwin Romulo, to tell you what they think of things. Anything, in fact. Let's go grab a quickie.
Welcome to Quickie. I am here with organ donor Erwin Romulo and Kim Arvilla, that dirty, dirty minx. And here, our topic for today is the oeuvre. Is it oeuvre? Eraserheads videos. Okay, let's get this party started. Okay, our first video is Ang Huling El Bimbo from the album Caterpillow. Directed by Aurelio Solito. Yeah.
I love this when he looks at the camera. Look, oh, this is just the moment.
Kilig.
One of my favorites.
Wait, is Buddy wearing leather pants?
This girl is cute, huh? What happened to this girl?
She's very cute.
This is directed by Matthew Rosen, who,
his wife,
Trivia, played a stormtrooper.
Lift your head, baby, don't be scared of the things that could go wrong along the way.
Next is With a Smile, directed by Ali Bundia and Mark Villena. Next is my favorite shot.
Yeah, who's this girl?
That is Isa Bizon.
It's Isa Bizon. She is the youngest sister of Yanni Uzun and Yael Uzun.
This is an Alice in Wonderland thing, I guess.
Oh, I guess.
Neil Gaiman was still big in the 90s. Well, he's really big. He's still big now. No one ever said that there's an easy way. Yeah, body looks great as an oso, which is bear in Filipino.
Yes.
Yes.
And I asked his
you know
wife.
What? He looks awesome.
Yeah.
Raymond's
a pumpkin.
Raymond's
I think he's a lobster.
That's a pretty pervy shot.
I wonder how Isa feels about that shot now.
And the Dappy and our quickie.